Hey guys, so guess what? I went to Ulta and they have a sale going on right now. They have the 21 Days of Beauty and I think the sale ends tomorrow. I'm gonna go back and get the Anastasia Beverly Hills, the brow wiz. It's on sale right now for like 10 bucks and I've always wanted one. So I'm definitely going back and getting one. But today I got some goodies. And I'm gonna show you what all I got. So yeah, let's get started. So first thing I got was I got two Tarte blushes because they were on sale today for $14 and they're originally, I wanna say 26, 28, something like that. So expensive. I got two shades. I gotta get them out of these boxes. It's like they almost don't want you to get in the boxes, right? Does anyone else have that problem or is it just me? Anyways, I got two. I got one in Exposed and Blushing Bride. Now, I've wanted these blushes, both of these blushes, for like 2 years. So, finally got them. I'm so happy. I'm gonna swatch them for you real quick. Just cause. This is the Exposed. Oh, we're taking a little swatch. And, oh, it's so pretty. Look at that. It's just like a nude... like a nude, but like a hint of pink, kind of brownish, but it's really good for everyday use. I've been wanting it forever. The next one is Blushing Bride. It's like a mauve-y pink. It's really like, I'm like flipping you guys off, but I promise I'm not. I always use my middle finger for like everything, eyeshadow, just everything. That's what I use it for. So, I promise I'm not flipping you off. But there's both of the colors. And I really like them. Like, they're good for everyday use. And especially this one in the fall. Like, I just don't think you realize how excited I am to finally have these two. Next thing I got is the Stila Magnificent Metals Glitter and Glow. It comes in this cute little packaging. Just says Stila on it. And it's like this glitter. But like, you know how like most glitters, like I have this one. I haven't used any other glitters but this one, by the way. I've got this gold glitter from Wet n Wild. Now, I want you to see what happens when I use this. And I'll just show you the difference between these two. But it's like tacky. It's like almost like glue. And when I swatch it, that's what the swatch looks like. Like, it's okay, but it really just feels like glue. And it's gross. Oh, the Stila, here's when you take it out, it's got like this, like a doe foot applicator, so it's really nice. I got a little much, but here, I'll just do a little swatch, and like, you can totally see the difference between these two products. Like, that one is like, has like a sheer, not sheer, like a shine to it. And like, this one's more like a champagne gold. Like, look at the difference. So much better. When you're wiping it off, it gets glitter everywhere, by the way. The next two things that I got were lip products. I got, no, I'm not gonna lie, I already opened it because I wanted to test it out. But I got the NYX Lingerie matte liquid lipstick, whatever. The NYX Lingerie liquid lipsticks. You know what I'm talking about. I got it in the shade Baby Doll. And it's got... the applicator's a little funny because, like, it's flat. So, like, some people will find it difficult to apply it, but I don't have a problem with it. But it's just, like, a really pretty nude color. Let me show you. Now, see... whoa, what's going on with the lighting? Guys, I don't know what's up with the lighting. I'm trying here. But that's what it looks like. And it sucks because it's almost exact to something I already own. And when I asked the lady, she was like, oh, no, no, it won't match that. We're gonna test this. So, Max Velvet Teddy. I'm pretty sure they're the exact same. Okay. Not super close, Mac Velvet Teddy has a little bit more of a rosy color. So I'll give it to her. It's not the exact same. So she wins this time. Either way, it's a pretty color. I like it. I really like the formula. If you have not tried the NYX Lingerie Lip Line, try it. It's amazing. You won't regret it. Okay, next thing I got was a NYX lip liner. Now, this is a staple for everybody's collection. Like, I have, how many do I have? I have four, and including this one, now I have five. But these, they just go on so smooth. Show you, what color is this, by the way? It's pale pink. I figured it's a good nude to go under any lip. It's really pretty. I like it. I'm sure I'll definitely use it somehow, some way. And the, I'm like getting real close to y'all. The next thing that I got was a brush. Now I've been wanting a highlight brush because like the one I'm using, where's the one I'm using? Guys, you should see my desk right now. It's like covered in stuff. Like I don't even know how I'm functioning right now. Give me a second. Okay, I'm back. I found it. But it's this e.l.f. stippling brush. I used it because I didn't want to pick up too much product. But when I do, it just goes everywhere. And it's just, it's way too big. So I needed to get something that was a little bit more small and more condensed. And I heard someone say this was a really good highlighting brush. It's the Real Techniques setting brush. Now this would be normally for like setting under your under eyes or something like that. But I mean, I'm sure it's good for highlight. Laura Lee used it. And I was like, oh, never thought of that. But it's just like this little tiny brush. And like, it's perfect for highlight right there. Oh, there goes the lighting again. But it's perfect. So I like it. It's pink. And who doesn't like a pink brush? So, hey guys, that's all. That's all I had. I never know what to do at the end of these things. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and subscribe down below if you want. No pressure. You don't have to. But hey, really help me out. So, thanks. Bye, guys.